apart from seeing a few fish crash out on the far reed line, I've decided to move one of my rods into the margin a couple of swims down. Now the sun's come out a little bit and it hits this bank, so rather than sacrificing both rods over there, I thought I'd mix it up a little bit and take one down a couple of swims. So I've whipped the left hand rod in and freshened up with a new bait. I'm going to go with a hinge stiff rig. The edges of the lake down here are quite mucky and that with leaves and debris and God knows what. So what I want to know is that obviously this bait's going to be presented on top of any of that perfectly. So I've got on a hinge stiff rig, little semi-stiff quarter, boom, good enough to flick away from the lead because it's only going to be an underarm cast, and enough suppleness to just rest over the top of anything. Quarter choddy, size 6, and one of the new Hinders Nut 365 bait that I'm testing. They mimic the freebies absolutely perfectly buoyant to hold this upright as well, just what I need to set over the top of any of the debris that's going to be in these margins, and there is quite a bit. I've dropped it in the margin just in front of my swim and had a look, and yeah, it sits upright and it looks decent. So I've taken a little handful of bait down there as well. I've just scattered that round off the edge of the tree. So just going to give this a quick spray and a quick boost, and then go and lower it in, and fingers crossed we might be able to snare one. But yeah, let's see what happens, and let's go and get this one in. Right, so no sooner have I been just talking to you about obviously getting that right hander, getting that left hander rod down in that margin. The rod that I said about fishing over to the reed line is just absolutely one tonered. It's only about, I don't know, 40 yard cast, 50 yards tops if that. But yeah, absolutely ripped off. So I've got that other rod obviously waiting to go down into the margin that I was talking about. And this one's just fishing over to the other side. We've seen a bit of activity this morning over that far bank as soon as we got here. So what we did is we put the rods out with just singles because we thought, you know, don't want to get plastered loads of baiting if they're already there. And this one's only been recast once because we felt we should have had a bite before then. Finally, it's taken off. Typical, just as I was already doing something, caught me unawares. Literally the minute I pressed stop on the GoPro, the right one that I said I was fishing over to the reed line with absolutely melted off, and this is a reward. It's been out there for a couple of hours with one recast and hinge stiff with the Hinders Nut 365 test bait, and this one's, like I say, this one's absolutely tore off. Lovely mirror, look at the scales on it, it looks absolutely immaculate. For a winter fish, I catch these all day long. The other side's just as pretty as well. Like I say, I've got that other rod just to go and stick down in the that margin, which I've just done, and hopefully we can nick one on that one as well. So what we're going to do, we'll slip this one back and get the rod back out on the spot, and hopefully nick one or two more.
Don't know if you can just see down there, that little rod just tucked away on its own just off this tree. It's about 12 foot off the bank, goes down like it was landing on that platform really, really hard. Lowered it down. I've just put a handful of bait down there, literally just, you know, enough bait to sit in the palm of your hand. Picking of 10 mils and a little picking of 14 mils of the new Hinders, like I say, the new Hinders bait, and that one's been placed down there. The sun keeps coming up and lighting up that little margin area there, so I'm hopeful of a bite. Just going to sit back away from this one. Like I say, it is a couple of swims down, so yeah, we'll just leave this one and let it do what it needs to do. But I'm confident that that one might go, to be honest. There's no pressure or anything down there. It's a quiet little area, quiet little reedy corner. So yeah, fingers crossed. We'll just let that one sit there for a little while. It's on a like I say, it's on a hinge stiff rig with the washed out white pop up. So that's going to sit down there nicely and like I say, be visible if anything does patrol through that area. So let's see what happens, and I'll come back to you shortly.
Right, so you're never going to believe this. Literally, that left-hand rod that I said I'd move down to the little margin area there, you're never going to believe it's gone off within, I don't know, 10 minutes tops. I was just sorting a few bits out over where we're sort of set up camp, and yeah, it's absolutely ripped off. The rod was borderline about to be dragged off the alarm. There's real grass all caught in the reel where I've kind of wedged it in to give it a bit of security, and yeah, it's absolutely taken off. And yeah, fish is pretty angry, gave me a good little scrap underneath the rod tips. It's only about, I don't know, 7-8 pound at best. Scaly little mirror. Fortunately didn't get any footage on the GoPro, kind of, you know, put it out not really anticipating anything was going to happen that quickly, and yeah, it's literally, like I say, it's literally tore off. Didn't get any footage of it on the mat either, unfortunately. It was just as angry on the mat as it was in the water. So I got Mark to take a couple of stills, so I'll put these up after this. But yeah, that move of that rod paid off, which I'm pretty glad about, to be fair. So put it back down there now. Another little handful of scattering of bait, and yeah, the nut 365 pop-up seems to be doing the business. Them 10 mils are perfect, they're so light, and like I said, they'll just rest on top of any debris down in that corner. So I'm just going to keep trickling in little handfuls of bait each time I get a take, and hopefully get them, keep revisiting that area. So fingers crossed for more.
Just had that fish that I showed you on camera, that I couldn't show you on camera, I could only show you the stills of. Literally sorted that out, got that one back in, handful of bait over the top of that margin left hand spot again, and lowered the rig back in, went back down to try and grab a cup of tea, because literally this morning's been manic, this last hour and stuff, not really had a chance to settle down yet. And yeah, the left hand has just melted off again. Obviously caught a bit unawares, so I got down to the rod and stuff, but it's already made itself into the margin, so managed to shed the hook, unlike the last one. So I've just dropped it back down there again with another handful of bait. Might take a little while for this one to kick back in again, because obviously you've seen two takes now in a short space of time. So I'm confident of another one. The spot's slowly starting to build, hopefully, and hopefully they'll start to revisit that area again. So hopefully now I can get back down and actually make a brew and chill out for 10 minutes, but I'm not going to complain when the alarms are singing. So Mark's not had anything yet. He did just have a possibly a savage liner. There might be a fish or something trailing something in here, but yeah, there was nothing on the end of that one, so we're still hopeful. We've got a lot of time left yet. It's just gone 11 o'clock, so yeah, fingers crossed. Let's go and get ourselves a drink and chill out, and yeah, fingers crossed for a few more fish on the mat. Savage take. Bobbin was wedged in the alarm. What is that on the mark?
It's on a bright yellow pop-up, mate.
Probably one out of my bucket, no doubt. See him sniffing around as I was putting a rod out. Got to be careful down here, because last time we was down here, there was an unknown snag down in the margins. There are obviously these trees obviously come out into the lake, so we have to be a bit careful down here, because yeah, we don't want any any snag fish after we've had to wait for a while for this one to go. I'll just grab your net for you, mate. Do you want me to try netting this out for you? Looks like a little common.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
He's a little fishy, don't have to give you a great little scrap. Full of energy. Oh, I ain't gotta scoop him. There we go. And he's in. Happy days.
Taking on a bright yellow popper, flavoured with a bit of peach and sweetener.
Little common, angry, as they all are. But it's a bite, and like I say, when the bites are hard to come by at the moment, we'll take anything. So we're going to slip it back, get the rod back out. I'm going to probably redo mine in the next half an hour, because I still reckon there should have been a bite or another. Something should have happened by now. So I'm going to get the rod in half an hour or so, just finish off what we're scoffing our faces with. And then, fingers crossed, we'll have a little bit more action. Right, so I've had a little move of swims. I've moved the rod down in that little corner reedy bay, moved it down one. I'd give it the best part of what, hour and a half, pushing 2 hours, and nothing returned since then. Those couple of fish in quick succession, obviously managed to land one, and obviously the other one escaped. But I'll put the rod back down and nothing's happened for a good couple of hours. So what I've done is I've just moved it into the next swim. Just fishing over to the other side. Good couple of rod lengths off. It's gone down nice and firm. Just onto some silt, and it's not plugged in or anything. So I'm going to give it an hour there. The guys that were down to our right have kind of moved in on the little point of the sort of shallower slash sort of little channel. So they've moved into there. If there's anything down there, they may push a few fish out, because there'll be four lines going in down there. Or they might get lucky, who knows. But I'm going to give it an hour in here, and then what I might do is just move this rod a bit further down into the swim, down to Mark's right. I might just move it a couple of swims down and just fish the margin, maybe for the last hour or so of the day, but just see what happens really. Might be able to make a fish out of this one, who knows. But my other rod, the rod that was out long towards that reed line, wow, it's actually going onto a real nice firm bed of clay. A couple of times when I was reeling in, there's obviously marks of clay on the lead, and on the retrieve of one of the other recasts, there's a nice clump of clay that have just nicked the hook, real soft clay. So that was where I had that scaly bigger mirror from. So I've come off that spot now. Again, that one's been out a good hour and a half at least, and nothing's happened on that one. So I've just moved it to the left a little bit, so it's more in the middle of that reed line, and just dropped it a little bit shorter. So let's see what happens and what pans out over the next hour. Obviously, if anything happens, then I'll come back to you. Just gonna listen to the footy on the radio and just chill out and have a brew and stuff. And like I say, if anything happens, then we'll come back to you, flip the camera on. Right, so it's just gone 3 o'clock, and decided to move the rod from further down. Decided that nothing was going to happen in that swim that I moved it down to, and obviously the guys from down this end have moved up that end for a couple of hours as well, so maybe there's a little bit of pressure up there now. But it's been pretty slow, to be quite honest. Once I'd have that flurry of fish, obviously I had two and lost one, and then Mark had one not that long after. Everything seems to have died down now, really quiet. When we first got here, we see a couple of shows on the far bank, which, like I say, made us chuck a couple of singles in their direction. But yeah, nothing really materialised after that. Like I say, I decided to move one of the rods into that bay that the sun was hitting onto, and yeah, that proved successful, because I managed to have a fish and obviously lose one pretty much straight after as well. So I've moved from down there. Like I say, I moved the rod into this swim. There's a couple of swims down from Mark's. It's got no pressure or no lines in the area, and all I've done is just flicked it, underarmed it down to where light meets dark on the water there. So I come down here and just put a handful of bait, just crumbed broken boilie in a tiny little bit of pellet, just sprayed it in a little arc, and I've just dropped the hinge stiff amongst it all. Like I say, there's no pressure or no other lines down here. Just got my rod, gone down nicely, and yeah, just going to leave it for an hour. Just going to do a little bit of, like I say, a little bit of a tidy up. It's just gone 3 o'clock, so we're going to give it an hour or so in this last swim, and see if I can nick one last fish. But apart from me and Mark, the other three guys that have been down here haven't had any carp. They've all had bream, so yeah, it looks like we've been lucky in that feeding spell. Obviously, my rod placed into that swim a bit further up was obviously in right place, right time to nick those two bites in quick succession. So it's been good. It's been nice to get out for a day. Like I say, get a bend in the rod, because it's hard this time of year. A lot of places and a lot of people are blanking and stuff, and sizes are relevant when you want to just hear the alarm sing. So it's been nice to get out and stuff, so that's all good. But yeah, hopefully in the next hour or so we'll have a fish, and I can come back to you and show you what's happening. But if not, I'll catch up with you later on, and like I say, we're just going to go and have a little bit of a tidy up. So fingers crossed for one last fish of the day. I don't care who has it, me or Mark. But yeah, it'll just be nice to round the day off with another fish. So yeah, we'll catch up with you shortly. Right, so just pulled up back up into the car park to the flat. Just after 4:30, and we decided to call it a day. Nothing else had happened since we had that flurry this morning, or around sort of dinner time-ish. Kind of had high hopes once we started catching those fish, to be honest. Obviously, I thought once we started to just move the rods around and just rove the rods around into different areas, we might be able to pick off different, you know, fish in different areas of the lake. But once I had those two, once I'd moved my left-hand rod a little bit further up the bank, like I say, once I had one and then lost the other one, that pretty much paid an end to that area. Didn't have any fish off that spot for a good maybe hour and a half, maybe pushing 2 hours. Decided to call that a day in that area, moved the rod back down and started to fish a different area completely. The longer range rod, I was just pretty much was just roving around in front of that swim, hoping to just pick off any fish that may be mooching up and down that margin. You know, we tried different coloured baits, different flavours and smells, you know, whatever we had in our bucket, we pretty much tried it on each time that we was moving the rods and stuff like that. So yeah, it was a bit of a disappointment for the day to go on and sort of finish off on a bit of a low. Like I say, once we had those fish, we kind of had high expectations that a few more might follow, but it's clear that that was just the short feeding spell for that day. And yeah, we made the most of it, really. There were three of us on the lake, and none of them caught any carp. I think they may have had one or two bream between them. So I think, you know what, two fish landed, I had, and obviously lost one as well, and Mark had one. I think we've done pretty well considering the circumstances around the lake with all the other anglers. So so yeah, it was nice to get a couple of fish on the new bait. It was nice to get a couple of fish under the belt for obviously the start of the year. I've done a couple of sessions here and there the last sort of over the last 6 weeks, and none of them really been have come to fruit as such, you know. it's just the way it is, I suppose. This winter, everyone up and down the country is having, you know, similar sort of problems with the weather and stuff like that, and places just shutting down, really. So yeah, like I say, it's good to get out, good to get a bend in the rod, and yeah, we'll see what happens. So hopefully you've enjoyed the video. It's not, obviously not much content to it in the sense of fish captures and stuff like that, but I just wanted to get back out and put another video together, really. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and obviously if you're on Facebook, pop on over to my page and come say hi and let me know what you thought of the blog. So I'll catch up with you soon, and thanks for watching.